So the final thing we'll take a look at is the boundary conditions. So again, we had in our T matrix, we had two terms that were, you know, one was like T minus a half, right? This corresponds to the boundary between the X0 grid block and the fake X minus one grid block, right? So this would be the transmissibility, T minus a half, right? And so if we had a constant pressure boundary condition there, well, again, looking at the flux Q, right? So the flux Q, Q is equal to T minus a half, which is equal to P0 minus P1. And that flux vector is going to be the same thing, it's going to be the same if we go from P0 to PB, right? The flux vector is going to be the same. It's just now our T is over delta X 0 over 2, right? And so if we were to work out all the terms, what you'd have is just a 2T 0 there, okay? So basically, equivalently, because the Qs are the same, the pressure drop then, so then basically what we're saying is that T minus a half is equal to 2T 0, right? Likewise, so this is again, this is for Dirichlet or what I call prescribed pressure boundary conditions. And for the other one, and I don't know if I ever said this, but another way, another name for the no flux boundary condition is a Neumann boundary condition, or no flux. So again, if we're talking about the right side, we'd have the grid block that corresponds to xn minus 1 and the fake xn. And here we have a flux, and that flux is equal to, in this case, T to the n minus a half P at n minus 1 minus P at n. And if there's no flux, the flux is 0, then there's no pressure drop. Therefore, you know, T at n minus half is equal to 0. Right? So in summary, for the boundary conditions in a heterogeneous system, if we have Dirichlet, you're going to have T minus a half, or this would be corresponding to the left side, or possibly if you had a constant pressure on the right side, T n minus a half, that would be corresponding to the right side. Those are going to be equal to 2 T I or 2 T n minus 1, right? Depending on left, right. Likewise, you're going to have, in those cases, Ti, but T0. Likewise, in those cases, you're going to have Q0 or Q to the n minus a half, I'm sorry, n minus 1 equal to 2 T0 PB or 2 T n minus 1 PB. Right. So again, this is if you have constant pressure or prescribed pressure on the left, this is corresponding to prescribed pressure on the right. Again, left, right. Right. So then if you had Neumann, it's even easier. In that case, your if Neumann on the left, which is the T minus a half, or on the right, T N minus a half, those are in either case going to be equal to zero. And again, Q, zero, or Q N minus one are both going to be equal to zero. So left, right. So those are your boundary conditions for your heterogeneous system.